Greetings, I'm Martin Crabtree from the Mercer County Community College Library. I'd like to spend a few moments talking about formatting your APA references page. Your APA references page is required as part of Lab 5 for IST 101. And it's really fairly easy and quick to format that page. However, many students lose points on this assignment because the page is not formatted properly. References page, we need to talk about what is required. Firstly, the word references is centered at the top of the page, and we use that plural term references because there's more than one source listed. The citations need to have a hanging indentation, where the first line is all the way to the left, second and third lines are pushed in a bit. Remember, all your citations need to be from within the past 2 years, so you want to keep all that information recent. So if you happen to notice as you're putting this together, you have a citation, an article that's from more than 2 years ago, you'll have to go back and find another article, again, to do this properly. Double line spacing is required. Also, the citations need to be in alphabetical order. And we want no live hyperlinks. Don't want any blue, any underlining. Should be just straight text for any sort of links that are part of the citation. Also, you want to use the same font style and same font size. When you copy things out of databases and drop them into a Word document, you may not have the same font style and size. So let's see how this is done. I have a references page that I started putting together here. I'm in Microsoft Word, and I put the word references at the top of the page. And I drop in two citations I got from library databases. So I'm going to start working on formatting the page. Most of what I'll be doing involves the paragraph portion of the home toolbar here in Microsoft Word. First thing I want to do, I just want to put that word references in the middle of the page. And I can do that with the centering icon right here. The lines are all kind of lined up in the middle. If I click on that while the cursor is somewhere in the line, it can be at the start of the line, the end of the line, anywhere in between, as long as it's on this line. If I click on this, it'll put it in the middle of the page. And that word references will remain in the middle of the page no matter what I do. If I change the font size, change the style, I can add text, I can delete text, and it will always remain right there in the middle of the page. Many times I see students kind of try to eyeball it, use the space bar and the tab key to move things over. But then once you have it lined up and appearance-wise and you change something, then it's no longer lined up. I also want to make sure everything is double line spaced, and I'm going to highlight everything, my two citations and the word references. And right here, this icon here, kind of the up down arrow with the lines, gives me the line spacing. If I use the drop down here, I can set it to double line spacing. I just want strict double line spacing, so I'll select 2.0. Now for the citations, I need to have that hanging indentation. So I'm going to highlight just the citations this time, not the word references. And off of paragraph, right here at the bottom corner, there's a little drop down. If I click on this, it'll bring up the paragraph settings. And the indentation section right here, here's where I set up the hanging indentation. And I want left and right to be set to 0. I want to go all the way out to the margins, left and right, but I do want a special indentation. Use the drop down here, select hanging indentation. And it should be default to half an inch. That's fine, I'll leave it like that. So I got two zeros, the word hanging, I'll click on okay. And now it rearranges things and puts the citations with a hanging indentation. You'll notice that this one link down here is blue and underlined. And I do not want a live link, and Microsoft Word often will turn on a link if you hit the enter key right after the end of a line with a citation, with a link in it. So again, if I point into the link anywhere within the link, I can point here and right click. I want to right click over the hyperlink, and right here in the middle, remove hyperlink. That's what I want to select, because I want to take away that hyperlink. And now I have the hyperlink removed for me. I also need to put my citations in alphabetical order. Now, because Lab 5 only has two citations in it, your chances are 50-50 that you will actually have it in alphabetical order when you first drop in your citations. Mine are not in alphabetical order, so I do want to alphabetize my list. So again, I'm going to highlight my two citations, And again, off of the paragraph box here, the A to Z button, A, Z dropdown, this is the sort button. This will sort things for me. And if I click on this, it'll bring up the window here. I want to put this in alphabetical order by paragraph. That's how Word thinks of each individual citation. It thinks of it as a separate paragraph. And I want to put it in text order. I want to put it in ABC order. I could put, say, in a numeric order or date order, but I want to stick with text, ABC order. I want it ascending, going from A to Z, not going the other direction. So again, I've been paragraph, text, ascending. Once I have those three set, I click on OK, and it will rearrange things for me. And this will work for, you know, you could do it for 24 citations if you have a larger list of sources. It works quite well. Last thing I need to do is make sure I have all the same font style and size. In this case, I'm going to use Times New Roman. So I'll use the drop down here and set it to Times New Roman. I'll use 12 point, commonly used font size, and click on 12 point. And now I have a properly formatted references page in APA, which is now ready to be turned in. One thing to take note of, you'll notice here in the second citation, kind of a big gap towards the end of the citation. That's okay. When there's a web address or something long like a web address, and some of these web addresses can be quite long, if it does not fit on that line, what Word wants to do is then drop it down into the next line. So what it did, it just moved it down to the next line in an attempt not to break it up in the multiple lines. So if you see a gap like that for the citation link, as this is here, then it's okay. You don't need to worry about that. Now it's your turn to put together your citation page. And remember, library is here to help you. So please contact us, library@mccc.edu. We're here to help. All you got to do is ask. Thanks.